Hey, this video is about a data structure called binary heap. It's a data structure that maintains a set of elements and gives quick access to the largest of them. An interesting feature of it, which makes it fast, which is one of the reasons it is fast in practice, is that it represents a tree using an array. So there are no explicit pointers to parents and children, which saves memory, which improves cache locality, and that makes it faster. But the size of the heap will change, which is why I will keep a separate integer to track its size. I will make two simplifications and I will leave those as modifications you might try at the end. So first I will just implement a heap of integers, and that's why there is an int here, not a heap of arbitrary data types that can be compared. And second, there will be a maximum size, so I will that's why this array is not a reference to an array but an array itself, so I cannot swap the array with something bigger. But both of these things can be easily fixed. For the sake of presentation, I will not do those now. So let's see how to navigate in this tree. The root is index 0, and the two children of index 0 are going to be stored at index 1 and index 2. In general, if I want to take the left child, then I do this. If I want to take the right child, and I do this. And conversely, if I want to go to the parent, I do this. Okay, let's write just a small invariant with what I said about the heap. To make it a bit more explicit. So first, the used part of the array is just a subset of the whole array. Second, I didn't say this actually, but the invariant of the heap is that the parent of a node is at least as big. So for the whole used part, we have that the parent is at least as big as the current element. Now you might notice what happens when I equals 0. When I equals 0, because OCaml uses the for integers division, the standard semantics of processors, which is not the standard semantics in mathematics, the parent of 0 is going to be 0, and therefore this inequality will check that a of 0 is at least a of 0, which will be true. So I don't need to treat that as a special case. But I know I don't need to treat that as a special case. Okay, now let's see how we insert an element, how we push an element in this, and how we pop. I will write the implementation because it's very easy. The idea is that I put it at the end, which might break the invariant, and then fix the invariant by moving it up, because the element I put at the end might be big. Function up I did not write yet. I will write it and explain it a little bit later. Its purpose is to re-establish the heap invariant. And popping an element will read it from the root. So the element that we return is gonna be what used to be in the root. We replace this element by, well, we decrement n first. We replace this element by what was at the end, and then we bubble down in A what is at position 0, and we'll also need the size of the array here. So we re-establish the invariant. Okay, so let me explain here a little bit what's the idea. So what you should see here is that pushing adds something at the end of the array, increases n, and re-establishes the invariant. How the invariant is re-established we'll see later. And pop, conversely, takes the last element, puts it at the very beginning, and re-establishes the invariant. And what it returns, by the way, it should be the former root of the tree. That's why I remembered it here. Okay, so what can go wrong if we push like this? Well, if we added something at the very end, this very end is going to be a leaf in the tree, and the invariant says that leaves should be small, but we might have put there a big value. It might be bigger than its parent. So if it is bigger than its parent, we're going to swap it with its parent, and so on recursively, until it's not bigger than its parent. So here we say, if A of I is strictly bigger than its parent, then we swap it, and we recurse. Again, notice what happens when I equals 0. Now, when we go down, what can go wrong for pop? What can go wrong for pop is that we took something that used to be a leaf, we put it now in place of the root, because we needed to take the root out and return it, so we don't have the notion of a hole here, so we put something in its place. But now that value might be too small, it might be smaller than its children, so we need to push it down. How do we push it down? How do we bubble it down? Well, we bubble it down by looking at which of the two children is bigger, and swap it with the bigger children, and we do so recursively. So it might be at some point that it is the biggest of the three elements. So when you look at one node and these two children, out of these three the root might be smaller, but it might also be bigger, and that's the case when you stop. So the first thing we do is that out of these three elements, I and the two children of I, we need to identify which one is the maximum. So we look at the three elements in turn, and j is going to be the index of the maximum. We look at first at the left children. We only take it into account if it is valid, so if it is within the tree. If it is not within the tree, it cannot be the maximum. And similarly, we look at the right one. And now j holds the index of the maximum. Of course, there's some small optimizations that can be made here, but I'm not going to do them now. So now, if j is not the current node, then there's something to do. Otherwise, we're done. We finished with bubbling down this thing. And what we do is very similar to what we do in the up function. We swap things. And now we go down J. Okay, let's test this a little bit. There's an error at line 9. Yep, this is a reference. Also, I forgot to implement a kind of important function. We need to have a way to start this thing. So I'm gonna write a make function that creates an array of size, maximum size, let's say 16. And now these things are recursive. Stop reference versus okay, this one is a reference. Okay. So let's play with it a little bit. We can make one heap, then we can insert in it some elements. I'm gonna type some thing randomly. Let's see at its content. Now we can notice here that position 0 is bigger than position 1 and 2, its children. Position 1 is bigger than positions whatever these things are, the next two, which are its children, and the next two that come here are going to be the children of this one, and they're smaller, and so on. So now if I pop an element, it will take the biggest out of these ones, which is 8. If I pop again, it's going to take the next biggest of those ones. If we look at the content of the heap, we see that the size is 5, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, but there's also some garbage at the end as we don't care about. So now if we push an element, let's say we push something which is kind of 3 in the middle, not the biggest, not the smallest, then we see that some new 3 appear there. If we push something big, it should come in the beginning. And that's it. Okay, so this is the code. Don't forget that there are two important simplifications. One, it only holds array, but this should be, it should be possible to keep any type as long as you have a compare function, a way to compare the elements. Second, it doesn't grow, and that's also should be fixable using a standard technique that grows arrays, and you might want to try both of these things. Okay, see you later.